करता हूं।
धन्यवाद, जय भारत।
धन्यवाद, धन्यवाद। डॉक्टर बालचंद्र मुंगेकर,
सर थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर अलाउइंग मी टू स्पीक ऑन दिस एंड बजट फॉर 2015-16। बिफोर स्पीकिंग अबाउट द डिटेल्स ऑफ द बजट, लेट मी टेक द अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ स्पीकिंग समथिंग अबाउट द फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ द पॉलिटिकल इकोनॉमी इन टर्म्स ऑफ विच द बजट इज टू बी एनालाइज्ड। दिस इज द फर्स्ट बजट आफ्टर 1952 which had been presented after the abolition of the Planning Commission. Sir, Planning Commission was a historical decision taken by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. He struggled for establishing that from 1936 Lucknow All India Congress session till 15th March 1950. He fought against the Congress colleagues who were opposed to the establishment of the Planning Commission. Now, under these conditions, I think that the Planning Commission was abolished under the pretext that central planning or centrally planned economy is no more necessary. It is elementary economics, sir, that India never had Soviet type centralized planning economy. It was always a mixed economy committed to the welfare state. It was always indicative planning, but it was an agency, it was an institution, it was the forum which was basically overriding the caste, language, regional considerations and monitoring overall economic development of the country. Under these conditions, I think it is the greatest disservice that the BJP government has made by abolishing the Planning Commission. Sir, with all apprehensions, I may be open for correction, but the way the ruling party and the ruling destination they are thinking about Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, a thought is lurking in my mind that one of the objectives of abolition of the Planning Commission was to abolish the intellectual legacy of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, which I totally protest. It is absolutely impossible to erase the legacy of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, because Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru has immersed in each and every particle of the soil of this country. Of all these colleagues, it is very difficult to overthrow the great. I don't want to go into comparison, but if single person is to be identified as the maker of the modern Indian nation state, then it was nobody other than Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Yes. Now, what has been brought in place of the Planning Commission? It was in brought NITI, National Institution for Transforming India, and NITI Aayog. I think government has totally failed the phonetics and the meaning of the NITI Aayog. Now, NITI means National Institution for Transforming India Aayog. Now, it amounts to saying that mai tumhe likhkar writing mein bhejunga. Now already you have got institution and then you are having Aayog. Either you can have NITI, but you can't have NITI Aayog. That's why immediately from grammatical point of view, it is necessary to call only NITI. You can't talk NITI Aayog altogether. Sir, the question here is that they are talking of transforming India. Now Planning Commission was basically for transforming Indian economy and incidentally transforming the social system. Now, I do not know whether NITI Aayog or NITI will be transforming India, but some organization definitely started transforming India through the religious bigotry. That is my main worry so far this transformation of India is concerned. Yes. Sir, Mr. Arun Jaitley as finance minister was extremely lucky to have the macro fundamentals of the economy properly in shape. The fiscal deficit was under control, current account deficit was under control, inflation was under control, and government intervention was not at all there. All there are external factors, and one would have expected Mr. Jaitley to produce a good budget. Unfortunately, he disappointed many of his friends as well as myself. I have got tremendous respect for him so far his knowledge of jurisprudence is concerned. Sir, the budget is not growth oriented at all. There is standard Keynesian theory. We said that the aggregate demand, which is consisting of the consumption demand and investment demand, both of them together determine the level of volume and employment. If we take into account 2014-15 and 2015-16, then the planned expenditure, earlier budgetary provision was 5,75,000 crore, and this time it is 4,65,000 crore. Even if we take into revised budget, it is absolutely at the same level. This means that there is no increase in planned expenditure. Now, it is stated in the economic survey that the private investment must be considered as the engine of economic growth. Now, between 2004-05 and 2011-12, investment was around average 85% of the gross domestic product. Of this, fiscal public sector was 9% and private was 26%. Of this 26%, corporate was only 10% and household investment was 14%. In order to stimulate the household sector investment, nothing substantially has been done. Sir, throughout, after 1991, and my party also is partly responsible, we have got the thrust on the foreign direct investment. Let me tell the House, and House, my many members are aware, whatever foreign direct investment has come to China in the initial year, during 1 month, that much foreign direct investment has not come during last 24 years in India. Such a large and big economy cannot be dependent or cannot be kept dependent upon the foreign direct investment. We have to increase the saving and investment rate to the extent of 35% of the GDP in the medium term and at least 40% in the long run. Sir, government has given new slogan, that is cooperative federalism. Sir, I am sorry that Jetli Sahib is not here. The constitutional history of federation, Switzerland, Canada, Australia, America and India, by the way, Indian constitution doesn't have the word federation, shows that cooperation is the basis of federation. It is superfluous to say cooperative federalism. And if at all cooperative federalism is to be understood, then there was the best period during Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. During the 17-year period of his prime ministership, he wrote 500 letters to the chief ministers. Another day I was reading, on 8th April 1950, Nehru signed the agreement with the Liaquat Ali Khan. The same day evening, 6 o'clock, he wrote the letter to the chief minister. And along with that letter, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru sent the copy of the agreement that he reached with the Liaquat Ali Khan. That is called the cooperative federalism. Here, planning commission was abolished on 15th August and thereafter subsequently meeting was called of the National Development Council. I don't know now National Development Council is available. Now, this cooperative federalism is talked about because many members spoke that 32% of the 13th Finance Commission to 42% of the 14th Finance Commission. Actually, figures are, if we take into account the budget to budget, then government has given 2.11 lakh, that is 2,11,000 crores less. If we take into account the normal central assistance and the loans and grants, that is reduction. Because of, in order to compensate the more resources to the states of the divisible pool following the recommendation of the 14th Finance Commission, if we compare budget to budget figures, 2014-15 and 2015-16, then the government has actually given 2,11,000 crores less. That is actually, if we take 70,000 crores less, and if we compare the budget estimates and the revised estimates, then government has given 41,000 crores more. But in return of this, government has transferred number of came to the states, and government has not evolved any mechanism. If the state government don't spend this amount, then what the government is going to do? There is no mechanism at all. A planning commission was an independent mechanism. Niti is just a club of 4-5% devoid of any political or economic power regarding decision making is concerned. And that is why Abhijit Sen, my colleague in the planning commission, he had suggested that initially, rather than giving 42%, make 38%, 4% you keep for separate, let us see how it is functioning and then you go for that. Sir, we have been talking about agriculture and agriculture backbone. Nothing has been done in agriculture. It is routinely, credit has been increased from 7.75 lakh crore to 8 lakh 50,000 crore. Only 5,300 crores of rupees has been given for the micro irrigation. Now, agriculture is the basically in the crisis in the country. Now, India is, Dr. Lohia always used to say, is the number one country in the world which is having maximum difference between Ukti and Kruti. The preaching and the actual actions. About women ke baare mein kya hota hai? The janani janma bhimishya swargada bigare esi. And what is happening to every, forget about the rapes, etc. Every family in this country, including middle class family, including intellectual family, is the major center of the domestic violence in the country. It is shameful. The rape, etc., that is far bigger crime. Now the question is, it is not growth oriented. The finance minister had made facilitating atmosphere for inducing growth, but no actual action plan. facilitating growth and taking actual concrete steps for growth, they are two different things. Budget is not at all inclusive. My colleague just now talking about inclusive. I have got 10 major sectors: women welfare, health and family, AIDS, urban housing poverty alleviation, school education literacy, drinking water, water resources and Gange Namami. Gange Namami has separate connotation. Then rural development, Panchayat Raj institution, and welfare of children. These 10 schemes taken together, which are the symptoms of the welfare state, the total resource set from budgetary to budgetary reduced from 3,90,635 crores to 2,90,853 crores. Sir, I never had the privilege of working on the Standing Committee on Finance, but my humble submission is to the Finance Minister, methodically let us try to understand whether we shall be year-to-year comparison, on the basis of the earlier year budget estimates, or this year budget estimates, or earlier year revised estimates, or this year budget estimates. Because earlier year's revised estimates are deceptive. There is always underperformance. Sir, one of my friend got 42% marks in SSC, 42% for BA, and 42% for MA. I said, how do you manage this? He said, I want to become consistent. I asked him that he did not born in 1942. He said, his father joined 1942 movement. Consistency, Ambedkar said, is the virtue of S. And it is from that point of view, I humbly submit, if this discontinue and as a supplementary guidance, if we do not revise the estimates of these, then basically it will amount to dismantling the welfare state. Sir, health expenditure. In 2012, during our regime also, it was 7.4% on health and education. Nepal spends 10.2%. Afghanistan is having one fifth of the total income of India, per capita income, spends 8% on health alone, as compared to India, only 4% of the GDP. Sir, the next point is about social justice, empowerment, tribal affairs, minority. These three ministries' budget have been kept constant, and I can submit to those. Development or for whom? Scheduled castes, scheduled tribes and minority, these three sections constitute 50% of the total population of the country. And if your total plan expenditure, what is the allocation for them? 0.01%. I mean, I have calculated these figures with respect to your this one. Then labor and employment, it is reduced. Micro, small and medium enterprises, I shall speak about this. I must submit that micro corporate sector, nobody is against your corporate sector. Let us not divide the country pro-corporate and, sir, I'm coming.
Two more minutes.
Just two, 3 minutes more, please. Yeah, just let me complete.
Okay.
Sir, now it is social component and tribal sub-plan. 22% of the total population of the country, scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. These two schemes were there. The resources were significantly, if we take into account budget to budget, then the special component plan, 19,598, and tribal sub-plan, 12,407 crores of rupees. If you take population proportion, then the reduction is absolutely substantial, but I don't want to go into that figure. Abhijit Sen's notes, sir, give me 2 or 3 minutes more, please. Don't give time next time.
Two more minutes.
Absolutely, thank you. What is this central assistant to state plan? Then Rashtriya Vikas Krushi Yojana and Backward Grant Region Fund. All of them three have been pruned or abolished. Bihar is the greatest tragedy of this, because 30% of this scheme, BRGF, was going to Bihar alone under the Bihar Reorganization Act 1970. Same is the fate of Rashtriya Vikas Krushi Yojana, which was instrumental for accelerating the agricultural growth. Sir, small, that is micro, small and medium enterprises. I was talking about corporate sector. If any sector of the economy, Honorable Finance Minister, make serious statement and responsible statement after agriculture, let us not chase the corporate sector. No, nobody is against corporate sector. Everybody accept these. These are not the days of command economy. But compared to corporate sector, if any sector in the economy, along with agriculture, is going to become the engine of economic growth, that is micro, medium, and small enterprises. And that's why I request you to prepare a separate plan, call a separate meeting of National Development Council only to deal with 92% of the total manufacturing, Ganalgoda sector employment is coming from these sectors alone. Now, sir, exemptions have been given. Now, exemptions have been given, 75,000 crores of exemptions have been given to the diamond and jewelry. And six, which is employing 30 lakhs people. And 16,000 crores have been given to textile sector, which is employing 45 million to 6 million people. Sir, last 2 points, 1 minute each. Mahatma Gandhi Employment Guarantee Scheme. It was a historic scheme, nowhere in the world, and in this context, I submit with due regard to the Honorable Prime Minister, Prime Minister's statement that Employment Guarantee Scheme is the edifice of the Congress regime, it was not in good taste. I submit to the House, from 2009-10 to 2013-14, total employment under Mahatma Gandhi Narega was 1,208 crore person years. 1,208 crore person years. We know employment elasticity of respect to growth. It is continuously declining. We are talking of demographic dividend. It is going to become demographic disaster. We are not doing anything from that point of view. Under these conditions, 50% households were scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. And one third of the workers were women, and that's why it should not be diluted.
Okay.
National Food Security Scheme, Shanta Kumar's committee report is coming, and
okay,
I am suggesting and warning that under no condition the National
okay.
Food Security Scheme should be diluted.
All right.
Sir, last, one minute. I must speak now something good thing about the budget, okay? And those good things are 4 crore houses in the rural areas and 2 crore houses in the urban areas. I congratulate. One suggestion, make these houses in the names of women in the country, and not a single house should be in the name of the man.
Okay.
Sufficiently for 100 years, sir, we are having male domination.
Yeah.
Mudra Bank, sir, half minute now.
No,
I am reducing. I will complete now by the time you are talking.
Sir, allow
no, no. Mudra Bank, I appreciate that 62% of these enterprises, they are from scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. But then when I was member of the planning commission, I suggested establish a separate national bank for the scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. For that, scrap all national finance development corporation for scheduled caste, for scheduled tribes and Safai Karmacharis. As we are having Mahila Bank, similarly,
okay,
they can take
all.
Care of that. Sir,
that's
only last
all, okay.
point.
That's
the
all.
Scrap, sir, half
no,
minute
no.
more.
Sir,
only.
By.
Sir
no,
please,
no.
don't.
No,
sir,
please.
Sir, half minute, sir. I am talking good thing about them.
No,
please.
No, that's okay.
One minute.
Yeah,
no,
Dilip Bhai.
Sir, as a correction of the public distribution system, I suggest the Honorable Finance Minister to scrap the licenses given of fair price shops to all the private dealers and give those licenses only to the women's
okay.
self-filled groups
yeah.
because they can run the better system.
Okay,
sir,
thank you. Thank